This video contains content that some might find disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
Thanks to Hunt a Killer for sponsoring today's episode of Are You Scared? Spooky season is my favorite time of year, and I like to do as many creepy activities as possible because I'm a spooky guy. That doesn't always have to be watching scary movies or going to scary events. Sometimes the scary event can be brought to your own home, and that's the case with Hunt a Killer. Hunt a Killer is an immersive game that brings people together with engaging storytelling. Check out their monthly murder mystery experiences and help solve a murder, something I don't know anything about. Each case is investigated over the course of 6 episodes, or boxes, that are sent to you once per month. Filled with letters, documents, clues, and physical evidence, you complete the objective of each box until you eventually crack the case and catch the killer. Congratulations! The Watcher team got together to play the all-new season of Hunt a Killer, starting with the first episode on Mallory Rock, a story about a suspicious murder in a small New England island community. Can't stand the suspense? Premium boxes are an entire themed mystery all contained within one box. Go to huntakiller.com/watcher and use code WATCHER for $10 off your purchase. And now, back to Are You Scared? Humans have long had a relationship of fear and fascination with the dark. The terror of what hides inside it, or the prospect of what can be discovered within it, always hanging in the balance. But for our narrator, he'll find that it's all too easy to get lost inside it. And even worse, what's waiting for him once he's done so. I'm Ryan Bergara, and this is Are You Scared? A show where I tell my friend Shane Madej the internet's scariest stories. So lock your doors, turn off the lights, and let's see if we can make it till the end of the night. Ted the Caver. The following was taken from a blog post hosted by angelfire.com from a man who called himself Ted. The post has not been modified in any way. It has been 3 weeks since our last visit to the cave. I want to update everyone about my condition, my plans for the cave, and the events that transpired during the past few weeks. I apologize for not returning your phone calls. I've been getting all of your messages, but I just haven't felt up to calling people back.
I'm already intrigued by this guy.
Why? Because he doesn't call people back?
Well, I mean, I respect that, but
I know
also,
you do.
I've never had a friend email me and say, I have an update about my plans for the cave.
That's true.
That sounds cool.
If you put that as the subject in the email.
My plans for the cave.
I'm hooked, baby. I'm calling you every day. I figure if I can get this site updated, I can let everyone know at once about how I am doing. A lot has happened in the last 3 weeks, so I'll do my best to cover everything. I guess I should start where the last entry left off. It took several days to get the last journal entry written down. I was so shaken up from the experience that I could do little else but sit around and ponder what had happened. Right now, I am on long-term medical leave from work. I've even been to the doctor, but because I couldn't tell him about the experience, I just told him I was under a lot of stress. He recommended rest and even gave me a prescription to help me relax. Good drugs.
Sounds like a good situation. Free drugs, don't gotta work.
Yeah.
Would you ever venture into a cave on your lonesome?
No.
No?
I'm always going in with a cave pal. A cave crew, if you will.
Sure, you're spelunking buds.
Yeah.
The thing I don't like is when there's ropes, where you gotta like climb up and down stuff.
Isn't that what spelunking is?
I think it is. I think you can go caving without going spelunking.
Yeah.
I like a cave that's sort of like a mall. You know, nice and flat, you can look around. Or the one at Knott's Berry Farm.
I don't think you've ever been in a cave.
I have. Eagle Cave in Illinois. Or maybe it's down by, yeah.
Eagle Cave, Illinois.
Yeah, look it up, you son of a bitch.
Doesn't even exist.
It does.
It does.
It's a beautiful cave. I'll tell you what.
There's one in Wisconsin.
Oh, it was in Wisconsin.
When we left the cave, I was nearly in a state of shock. I could not think clearly and was having a difficult time trying to process what had happened. B and I parted ways after the trip. I didn't try to reach him, and he didn't attempt to get a hold of me. Neither of us even tried to contact Joe. B dropped me off after the trip, and I spent the next several days by myself in my house. I couldn't find anything to do to take my mind off the experience, which is when I determined that I should write it down. I guess it was kind of therapeutic, but unfortunately, it didn't last. As a matter of fact, it was soon after that when things got really bad. I let my answering machine take any incoming calls and remained in a depressed state until a week after the trip. Then things started to get strange. At first, I was hearing sounds in the house that had no explanation. Footsteps, shuffling noises, creaking doors. You know, the typical horror movie fare. Only the sounds were not distinct. I never felt fully certain whether I heard what I thought I heard. I would be eating dinner or getting out of the shower and suddenly stop in my tracks, thinking I heard something. But the sound would never repeat itself. Either way, I was scared.
That's getting in his head.
Are you scared? I was scared.
This guy's psyching himself out.
This sounds like me on any overnight stay at a haunted house.
That's true. Yeah, you get you sort of get the jimmies.
I get the willies for sure.
Yeah, you go, shush, you shut up, you always say. He yells at me.
Well, sometimes I need to capture the evidence without you going, waka, 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 waka.
You just invite
like,
me.
God,
you
do you ever
me.
Shut up?
A few times where you've gotten legitimately angry.
I don't know if I got nasty.
You've
I
just, gotten nasty.
I just want to catch the evidence.
He's gotten nasty.
And you're there polluting it with that dirty hole of yours.
Dirty hole?
That dirty face hole.
Do you speak of my mouth?
Yeah. It was as though I had been caught in a spider web for the entirety of the past week. Paralyzing feelings of foreboding completely filled my life. Then came the hallucinations. I began seeing things in a manner similar to the sounds I was hearing. Just fleeting glimpses of something in the corner of my eye. When I would turn to look, nothing. I had been sleeping with the lights on in my room. But now I made sure to keep all the lights in the house on from before dusk all the way to after dawn. Once again, I paid the doctor a visit, but omitted any details of what was happening in my life. I simply told him that I was unable to relax, and I walked out of there with a prescription in hand. Fortunately, by then, my wounds and injuries had pretty much healed. When I was on the medication, I felt great. But I didn't want to walk around high the rest of my life.
That makes one of us.
Disagree. In this economy?
Check the box for no for me. So I would only take it at the end of a tough day. Unfortunately, I kept seeing things, which drove me to regularly take the pills. I continued to see the flashes in the corner of my eye. Then I began to see shapes and shadows. I would see them outside my windows. Usually at night. I couldn't make out anything, and it was hard to pin down exactly what I was seeing. I began to close all of the blinds and drapes in my home so I could eliminate any possibility of seeing anything. My life was in shambles, and my daily routine felt mechanical and empty. I would sleep in as long as I could and still wake up exhausted. I would then clean myself up and try to eat something. Especially since I had lost a significant amount of weight. I refrained from leaving the house and spent giant chunks of my days on the internet, where I began obsessively researching caves and cave myths.
Sounds a lot like 2020.
Yeah, that's true.
Where's time going? What's happening?
However, the only story I could manage to find was the caver folklore about the Hodag. A creature that supposedly roams in caves.
But see, if I saw that in a cave, I would not be scared by that. That looks very funny.
No, and Hodag's not really a name that strikes fear in my heart. That sounds like, you ever see like a guy that just makes up like a funny nickname? Like, you're like maybe as a barbecuing. Oh, can you get me that Hodag over there?
Yeah, pass me a Hodag order.
2 weeks after we had entered the cave, I began to have nightmares. Extremely lucid nightmares. no specific themes, but the same feeling of terror. Sometimes I was in my house and an intruder was trying to get me and I couldn't run because I had no legs. Other times I was in a vat and someone was filling it with syrup-like liquid. Every time I would wake up in a panic, then proceed to stay awake until exhaustion forced me to enter dreamland once again. It was a brutal routine that continued for several days until yesterday, when it reached its climax. One evening, I was walking from the living room to my bedroom when I looked down the hall and saw a dark figure at the end of it. Thinking it was a thief that had broken in, I began to back up slowly. It didn't move an inch. As I backed up, the lights began flickering off and on. Every muscle in my body was completely tense. The moment I stopped to look at the figure again, the phone started to ring. It startled me so badly that I stumbled over a chair behind me and fell.
I imagine this is what people think happens to me at my house every night. Yeah. That I'm just walking around, tense as shit, a phone rings and I'm toppling over chairs and Mari's just like,
fuck. Chill, dude.
This is why we can't have nice furniture.
I gotta say, for a story about a guy who calls himself a caver, he sure spends a lot of time putzing around his fucking house. What's yeah. going on here? Let's get his ass into a cave.
When I got up, I whipped around to look back at the end of the hall, but the figure had vanished. I grabbed my keys and fled the house. Might be going to the cave now.
He better be going to the cave.
I felt compelled to get in the car and drive away. My pulse pounded in my temples as I got in the car and started the engine. I had the sudden, overwhelming urge to drive to Overlook Point to see the city lights.
When? Again, the opposite of a cave.
Wait, what?
I want to be high up and look at a wide expanse. No! Get in the fucking cave, Teddy!
I had no idea why I needed to go there, but I knew that I simply had to go. The closer I got to the destination, the more urgent the feeling grew. When I arrived at Overlook Point, I was met with something that startled me at first, but a feeling of relief soon followed. Joe was there. He was standing next to his car, looking at the lights. Our eyes met.
Where is this going?
I don't know. They've all been lured here by some entity.
Well, it was starting to get romantic.
Oh yeah, maybe they'll kiss.
He's like, I'm going to the lookout point. I knew I needed to be there. Wait, Joe's here? Our eyes met.
What if in the story it was like, Joe was there, looking like a total 10.
Yeah, he was looking like a whole goddamn snack.
And I could see from the exhaustion on his face that he had been going through the same miserable trial as I had been. Our conversation was strangely brief. You've been back? He asked, even though he knew the answer. Yes, I said. We need to return. Is tomorrow good? I asked. Yeah, noon. He got in his car and I got into mine. I had no desire to talk to him about his experience, and he obviously didn't want to know mine. I drove over to B's house. When he answered the door, I noticed that B looked like he was doing fine. He even looked somewhat happy. However, he took one look at me and his disposition dramatically changed. This conversation was similarly short-lived. I ran into Joe and we're going back to the cave tomorrow at noon. B gravely nodded his head. I asked him if I could spend the night at his house and he gladly let me in. I didn't realize it until later, but every light in his house had been turned on. He led me to his spare room. Help yourself. Thanks, I said. I washed up in the bathroom, took some medication, and got my first decent sleep in a long time. I woke early in the morning and came home to get ready for the trip.
You know, just a sleepover with all the lights on in the house with you and your bros.
Normal, yeah.
That's how all my sleepovers
Fine.
Were.
Yeah, you go to your friend's house and he's like, let me show you my cave videos. I'd be like, oh, I thought we were gonna play Skip-Bo or something.
Yeah, I thought we were gonna play Super Mario Golf or something.
What are we doing here?
I don't wanna see your creepy slideshow that's all, by the way, pitch black because you didn't use a flash, you
just
dipshit.
Imagine Ted sitting next to you, just moving through the slides, not even looking at them.
Just see your reaction.
Look at this one.
Yeah, they're all the same thing, dude. It's a selfie with a flash on. I always see your stupid face.
Do you think it's scary? Have I told you about the Hodag? you know? Awful.
I thought I would send out this update so no one will wonder what's going on with me. I suspect that by the time most of you read this, I will be back home and will have a great story to tell. I promise that if you haven't heard from me by now, you will very shortly. It is now 10 a.m. on Saturday the 19th. We will be leaving for the cave in 2 hours. The process of preparing for this trip will be like no other trip I've been on. For the first time in my life, I will carry a gun into a cave. I will also carry a knife, an extensive first aid kit, plenty of food and water, and a camera. I will bring several sources of light and a pad of paper and pencil. I will have to take all of my climbing rope, since B lost his in the cave the last time we were there.
Idiot.
Fucking loser.
You call yourself a caver, you're gonna lose all your rope?
Cut some loose.
Yeah.
Take the loose ends back
home. That stuff's expensive.
It seems like careless rope management by B. Not everyone could be a caver, you know what I mean?
That's true.
I will carry a good length of rope with me for the other side of Floyd's tomb. This is the first time in 3 weeks that I even thought about Floyd's tomb. It sent shivers up my spine just typing the name. There are so many answers I hope to find in a tiny passage hidden from view. Reflecting on the events leading up to today leaves me feeling dizzy. Was this all a bad dream? Unfortunately, I'm well aware that I'm wide awake, and that in a few short hours, I might be facing my worst nightmare.
Is it sad to say, I kind of want to see him go in this cave and see what the fuss is about. And I realize that means he's probably going to die, but I do want to see what all
he's
the
a
fuss
character
is about.
In a story, so I feel okay saying this. I want him to die.
Just get on with it already.
Yeah, if he's a real person, I wouldn't be rooting for him to die, but
yeah,
he's a real mope.
The thought of having another person with me in the passage does nothing to alleviate the fear I feel. Who will lead our way into the dark unknown? Who will decide when to turn back? And the foremost question in my mind, what happened to the video camera that I left behind? It is supposed to be able to record in complete darkness, and I left it running this whole time. What would we find on that tape? Or what if the camera is gone? What if it was destroyed while we were gone? Although it is difficult to give my main motivator a name, I think closure fits quite nicely. The main thing I long for is to find the end of the cave. With all of the unsettling things that I have experienced during the past few weeks, it seems bizarre to even want to reach the end of the cave, but it is what I desire most. However, if I end up reaching the end of the passage, I will be content to never return. Never.
I've never heard someone talk about a cave so much and not get in the cave.
Yeah, if I were B, I'd be annoyed with these two. Because B sounds like he was just chilling.
Yeah.
And then they showed up at his door and they were like, we have to go back to the cave. I'd be like, Jesus Christ, with the cave again. Alrighty, fine. We'll go back to the cave. And then you drive them to the cave and the whole time the guy's like, I think I will call this closure.
I think
you're like, yeah, could we stop for some donuts or something?
Yeah, let's call it Let's Get Moving. That should be the name of your main motivator.
This guy sounds insufferable. Just cold clocks. Shut the fuck up, Ted.
I know that many of you don't agree with my decision to return to this cave. That's clear from the messages I've been receiving. I'm afraid I don't have a choice. If I ever want to have another good night's sleep or walk the halls of my own home in peace, I must return. I no longer feel that I have a choice. I must return.
Oh my fucking God! Get in the fucking cave!
For my family and friends who are reading this, I say, be at peace. I will conquer this cave. Then I will return and update this website right away. I will include any photos we take in the cave today, and if you stop by the house, I will show you the videos I retrieved. I expect to be home later tonight, or tomorrow at the latest. See all of you soon with lots of answers. Love, Ted. Ted was never heard from again.
So, are you scared?
That's not the end. That's it! I get the feeling that viewers are going to be livid that we don't have any cave time in this story. So I challenge the commenters to chime in below with
the rest
one
of the
final
story.
Blog post from Ted about what happened in that cave.
Yeah, send in your cave stories, your Ted cave stories. And might I encourage a very vicious and graphic death.
Just Ted. Really fillet the guy.
That was actually written by an anonymous person. And it was actually on a blog called angelfire.com. We'll include the link in the description. I'm gonna assume that that is not a real man. I do love the idea that he just never went back to the cave and couldn't live with the embarrassment, so he just stopped blogging.
Could be. He was really, he was really hyping himself up.
I'm gonna do it.
I swear to God, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna go to that cave. You guys are gonna be so proud of me.
I guess we'll see you next time on Are You Scared? Don't go chasing waterfalls.
Huh? Bye.
There's usually a cave behind a waterfall.
Oh. Ha 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 ha.